Hi, I'm Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, and I'm here to wrap up the year 2008 at the movies. I am going to tell you what I thought were the best movies of the year and what I thought were not just the worst movies of the year, because who cares about that, but the worst letdowns. So let's start with the best. I have to go with Gus Van Sant's Milk, with the performance of the year by Sean Penn playing Harvey Milk, a kind of gay social activist in the 70s who was assassinated right after he became the first gay man to be elected to public office in the United States. This could have been one of those biopic nothing movies where we just went, then I did, and instead it becomes electric. It becomes very much what Obama is about now as our new president. He is a guy who is coming in here saying, what do we do with the mess?
These people are going to live a life of such open homosexuality. They are going to be removed from their job.
We're going to beat this thing. We need everyone.
We lose this. We'll have anti-gay laws in all 50 states.
I know you're angry! I'm angry!
All the fight that Harvey Milk did in San Francisco to make something happen in terms of human rights and social activism is what makes this movie so full of energy. Sean Penn is great, Josh Brolin is terrific as Dan White, the guy who assassinated him. Because we feel for everybody in this movie. We have a movie that jumps off the screen and comes alive.
You'll be the first openly gay man elected to major office.
I think you're part of the machine now.
Society can't exist without the family.
We're not against that.
Can two men reproduce?
No, but God knows we keep trying.
Number two is real close to Milk. It's Slumdog Millionaire from Danny Boyle. This is the movie that's set in Mumbai. It's a love story that mixes in this quiz show, this version of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire that goes on in India. And the young boy that goes on the show doesn't really care what he wins. He cares only about finding the girl of his dreams who's gone through every kind of traumatic tragedy that she could go through in the world and what will bring them together.
We went on the show because I thought she'd be watching.
She's my destiny.
This movie from Danny Boyle, who did 28 Days Later, who did Trainspotting, is doing the best piece of direction that you'll see this year, and also the best cinematography. So, a great movie. Number three, here's me, the guy telling you about indie movies, the ones that don't come from major studios. And yet, number three, I have to go with the second most successful box office movie of all time, which is The Dark Knight. There are some of you out there that think The Dark Knight only deserves to be talked about because of the late Heath Ledger's performance as the Joker, which is great and deserves the Oscar. But not true. I mean, The Dark Knight works on so many levels, on political levels as well. It is the popcorn movie with a mind and a heart. So if you haven't seen it yet, and I think maybe there's two of you left, go see it or see it again.
You can make the choice that no one else will face. The right choice. Gotham needs you.
A little fight in here. I like that.
Then you're gonna love me.
Now that's more like it, Mr. Wayne.
So those are my three best. So now let's go to the worst. It's boring for me to tell you how bad Kate Hudson movies are or how rotten it is to see all those Chihuahua movies that are in my scum bucket. So I'm going with the letdowns. And the biggest letdown of 2008 for me is Quantum of Solace, because I love James Bond movies. I totally adored Casino Royale, the first James Bond movie to star Daniel Craig. And here he comes and does the second one, and what happens? All the stuff that was charming, that was funny, that had any kind of substance in Casino Royale has gone, gone out of Quantum of Solace. Sorry, it made me miserable. Number two, I have to go with the hideous, huge, epic Australia. I mean, Baz Luhrmann, the guy who did Moulin Rouge, this is a wonderful filmmaker, and he's writing about his own homeland. And what does he do? He's like using computer-generated effects. It's cornball. Nicole Kidman, it just gives the worst performance of her life. Nobody is seeing it, really. It's just not a movie that captured the imagination of anybody, and you know what? It shouldn't have. Okay, number three. Twilight. Huge hit. I wanted to love it. The vampire movie. The human girl falls in love with the vampire. Kristen Stewart falling in love with Robert Pattinson. Both good actors, both wonderful performers. But why did they mess up the book so much? Why do the special effects seem so tacky? Why is it all such a mess? Well, this has become a paycheck kind of thing. You know, they've gone into production on the second one. They fired the director, Catherine Hardwicke, because they need to get it out by next November to get your money. That's all they care about. This is the worst letdown in Hollywood, where all we care about is the buck. We don't really care about making a good movie about it. I have to say, I can't wait to go on to next year, where I wish I had hope that Hollywood would change, but it wouldn't. What we need to do is to change when we see movies disappoint us and let them know it and give a resounding boo to paycheck movies. I'm Peter Travers.